cocaine, everything. Until about 100 years ago, when America appointed its first drug czar, a man named Harry Anslinger. In his report to the U.S. Senate, Anslinger detailed the reasons drugs must be outlawed. This is what he said. There are 100,000 marijuana smokers in the U.S., and most are Negroes, Hispanics, Filipinos, and entertainers. Their satanic music, jazz, and swing result from marijuana use. It causes white women to seek sexual relations with Negroes, entertainers, and others. Anslinger's popularity soared with voters, and lawmakers began outlawing drugs. Then the evangelical movement inspired Congress to ban alcohol as well.
Gangsterism was a natural sequel, and battles for exclusive territories erupted with a violence unparalleled in the history of law enforcement.
Guys like Al Capone were suddenly making big bucks. The black market exploded with such violence that public opinion turned, and Roosevelt ended alcohol prohibition, crushing the burgeoning industry. But Harry Anslinger didn't stop pushing drug prohibition. In the 1960s, he took his case all the way to the United Nations and lobbied the whole world to adopt the U.S. policy of outlawing drugs. Richard Nixon would pick up where Harry Anslinger left off.
America's public enemy number one in the United States is drug abuse.
While publicly claiming to address addiction and violence, Nixon used drug policy as a weapon to move against those he thought of as his political enemies.
Homosexuality, dope, immorality generally, these are the enemies of strong societies. That's why the communists and the left-wingers are pushing each other. They're trying to destroy us.
The bastards that are out for legalizing marijuana is Jewish. The crisis is a matter of the Jews, Bob. What is the matter with them?
To fight and defeat this enemy, it is necessary to wage a new all-out offensive.
President Nixon created the Drug Enforcement Administration with an annual budget of $65 million and started the war on drugs. If you were a governor